Our people are in want. The economy is in dire straits, with the exchange rate now at about 540 to a dollar from the 150 to a dollar when PDP left office. Prices of foodstuff and essential commodities are unsustainable, clearly beyond the reach of the average Nigerian. Between 35 to 40% of Nigerians are unemployed, and women and youth bear the main brunt. Bandits, kidnappers, terrorists are having a field day almost unchallenged. Our children are not safe even in their schools. Corruption still stole the land. Nepotism, ethnic jingoism, and religious bigotry reign supreme in today's APC Nigeria. Our infrastructure is comatose. Trust and hope in Nigeria is at its lowest. Our lamentations can go on ad infinitum. But the test of leadership is the ability to solve problems. What solutions will PDP offer? What is the way forward? Well, this is why we have gathered here, to brainstorm and offer solutions and policy options for Nigeria. We cannot only criticize, we must provide workable solutions and clear policy alternatives. This will be presented to the Nigerian people. A sharp contrast must be drawn with the really incompetent and ruthless APC administration. PDP has shown that it has learned its lessons. It is ready for power in 2023 to provide hope where ineptitude currently exists. While APC thrives in excuses, PDP will take responsibility. While APC thrives in propaganda and deceit, PDP will be transparent with Nigerians. While APC government thrives in insecurity, PDP will scare Nigeria. Whereas APC presides over Nigeria as the poverty capital of the world, PDP will make Nigeria prosperous. APC has wrecked our economy, but PDP will salvage it. While APC focuses on selective anti-corruption fight, PDP will fight corruption with appropriate institutional reforms. This split has assembled an array of experienced experts, political party administrators, economists, and other faculties. While we await these interventions, permit me to mention an issue of great importance. Nigeria must embrace restructuring to survive. It must restructure its policy, economy, security, and ways of doing things. It must embrace collective autonomy and decentralization of power. This will unleash the energies of our people, especially the young. It is time to allow Nigeria to blossom. It is doable with all hands on deck. Secondly, we must embrace innovation and technology as a way of life. Technology will solve the youth unemployment time bomb. Technology will improve our agriculture, our healthcare, our industrialization, education, and indeed, it has implications and impacts on all facets of our lives. It is in this respect that we continue to condemn the Juja ban as a retrogressive action that should never have happened. Can Nigeria survive another 4 years of APC? The answer is a resounding no. It is too frightening to contemplate. PDP remains the only credible alternative to APC, and we cannot afford to fail Nigerians. We must keep hope alive. We can do it. Yes, we can, as Obama would say. The revitalized PDP shall be true to the words of our national anthem, to build a nation where peace and justice shall reign. With these words, I welcome you to this all-important retreat, and I wish you all the very best. Thank you very much, and God bless you.
Thank you very much, Your Excellency. This deserves much more than that. A clap, please. PDP is back. PDP is ready. PDP is now again to rescue and build Nigeria. Nigeria is in permanent emergency. Thank you very much, sir, for that opening address. We want to welcome the Senate Minority Leader, former Deputy Governor of Abia State, His Excellency Senator Enyinna Abaribe. Welcome, sir. We welcome the Governor of Edo State and Chairman of PDPE Registration, Mr. Godwin Obaseki. His Excellency, you're welcome, sir.